Hi, I'm Rob Moran, and this is how to impress your friends with your jazz knowledge. So, today we'll be covering, a couple of artists. Starting with, as you can hear in the background, I'm playing a little artist, you might have heard of him, his name is Miles Davis. This is Kind of Blue. It is the best-selling jazz album of all time. This is So What, and man, you should, when buying speakers, you should always test with two genres. One is rock, two is jazz. And if you're ever looking to buy a new pair of speakers, test with Flamenco Sketches from Kind of Blue by Miles Davis. The soundscape and like dynamic range on that is like what it's second to none. So it's really above par. It's Miles Davis. Up next is Anita O'Day, and I can't remember the name of the album. Recorded live at the Berlin Jazz Festival. Okay, so the reason I chose this is, I'll give you the matrix number. It's not too destroyed. MB20750 is the matrix. And it's a really nice, I believe that's a pencil sketch of Anita O'Day. And it's cool, she covers the Beatles on here. She does Honeysuckle Rose, which is one of my all-time favorite Anita O'Day songs. Yesterday's, yeah, Lennon McCartney, she covers that. That is such a cool version of her rendition of the Beatles. It's like the Beatles like you've never heard it before. So, get this album. Oh, and a really cool thing about the collector that owned this before me is he taped in the review of this album. So I'll read it to you, actually. Anita O'Day, recorded live at the Berlin Jazz Festival. It's a BASF recording, which is usually comes from Japan. So I believe this is a Japanese import. Several of these songs, it's four and a half stars. Several of these songs have been done by Anita O'Day on two albums recently released on her own label. Compare versions, and it's kind of water damaged. Not water damaged, like just antiquated paper. As done by superb artists like O'Day, it's about finding new possibilities in a piece of every time out. It's about taking a chance with phrasing and knowing you'll find a way to surprise the audience and possibly yourself. It's about working with the trio, keeping an ear out for unexpected chord or rhythmic turnaround, and jumping on the bandwagon. So this was released in 1970, and I wish I could tell you who the reviewer was. As a music reviewer myself, I would like credit when, you know, credit is due, but he didn't include it, so tough noogies. This next one, Night Train, Oscar Peterson Trio. Matrix number is V68538. And the best thing about these Verve jazz recordings, or just the Verve label in general, is they always include a review on the back of why it's so special. A great song on here is obviously Night Train, the title track, and Honey Dripper. If you know about Robert Plant's later career, I don't know if this is why, but he has a band called the Honey Drippers, and who's to say that it's not influenced by Oscar Peterson Trio? So this is another really, really great jazz album, and a pinnacle part of my collection alongside my Miles Davis discography. I don't have all Miles Davis, but I have quite a few records of this, but this is really, really special to me. So this is what's playing right now, Miles Davis, Kind of Blue. It sold about 6 million copies Don't quote me on that. It is a platinum record. Let's see. It is not an original pressing. However, you can get one for about $120. And the original pressings that I've seen on Discogs are never in good shape. So, very difficult to find a near mint to mint copy original pressing of Kind of Blue. But what's cool about this is the six eyes, the six Columbia eyes. Where is it? Over here. On the red label. But yeah, this is... I wish I knew more about this album. I haven't done extensive research on this album. I do know a lot about Sketches of Spain, which I didn't pull. But it's got John Coltrane playing tenor saxophone, Wynne Kelly on piano, Bill Evans on piano, Julian Adderley, and yeah, that's it. And man, I mean, what a lineup, you know? Those are some huge, huge powerhouse players in jazz. I mean, yeah, no one blows horn like Miles, so. This is Mingus at, can't pronounce, Montreux. sorry. Sorry, I'm not sorry. This is a really, really great album. Atlantic SD 16031. Sketch 2 is a great song. Fables of, Balbus. He plays for 8 minutes and 16 seconds. And I believe the whole thing is improvised. That's big with jazz, improvisation. So that's Mingus Dynasty live at Montreux. And that is something you should own in your collection. So. Up next is Antonio Carlos Jobim's Stoneflower. He played with Getz and Gilberto on, you know, he did that whole, like, Girl from Ipanema and, you know, that whole album. And, I mean, this is Bossa Nova, but it's really great music. Look at the way it comes in the sleeve. This is how I keep my record, so you can just go like this. You can just... Okay, this is backwards, but you should be able to just pull the record right out. But it's really cool. Really nice presentation. Really nice album artwork. I mean, that's really a great photograph. But he's got, like, children's games on here. It's weird. On the back... Oh, it's a whole... Okay, so... I try and keep my records in great shape, so I don't really take them out of the sleeve that often, unless there's lyrics to read. But this is a whole gatefold, so that's really, really cool. But it's got Teresa My Love, Children's Games, which is a personal favorite song. Start with Children's Games is my recommendation on that. And then go from there. Explore Jobim. He's a great Bossa Nova Brazilian artist. And I highly recommend him. Okay, so. This particular album was the first jazz album I bought. This was kind of like my introduction to jazz. I got my first record when I was 15. And it was a Jimi Hendrix record. It was a compilation record. And, I hadn't ever really listened to jazz before, and, you know, I went to the record store, and I started, you know, flipping through the jazz stacks, and, I found this, and I'm like, wow, this is live, and it's Miles Davis, you know, Miles Davis, kind of cool, you know, so I bought it, and I was never so impressed with a jazz album, I was never so impressed with, a musician, so I bought more, and I bought more, and I bought more. And now I have so many jazz records. I have so many records to go on. But this is Miles Davis and the Tad Dameron Quintet in Paris, May 1949. You guys can read it, obviously. But Riptide, Don't Blame Me, Those are awesome, awesome songs. And it's a radio broadcast, so there's somebody speaking in French throughout the album, and it just kind of adds to the texture of the album to me, and just adding to the uniqueness of the album. I believe this is a very common album, but the landscape of this and the way they improvise and just kind of know when, like, the way jazz musicians work is they just know, they use their ears, so they just know by listening. And the way that these guys, like, jam together, or not jam, jive, is the, you know, correct jazz term. It's just incredible. So, the matrix number on this is, come on, Columbia 34804. And you can type all that into Discogs. Let's see. Now, it wouldn't be appropriate to do a jazz review if I didn't talk about Billie Holiday. This is Billie Holiday singing the blues, but it's still Billie Holiday, and it's still fantastic. So, Billie Holiday sings the blues. If you know her voice, Madeline Peru, I did a review once about her, actually sounds a lot like Billie Holiday, so she's another artist you should look at. But Billie sings the blues. They can't take that away from me. Swing, Brother Swing. I Cover the Waterfront. I mean, the song span from 1937. They can't take that away from me. You know, they can't take that away from me. So Don't Explain. This is a great, great album to own. And the matrix number is SPC 3335, and it's a Pickwick recording. So that's a really cool album. This is like more contemporary jazz. Let's see when this was released. Um, 1980. So I don't know if the term neo applies here, like neo jazz or contemporary jazz, I suppose is what it's called. I'm not very good with jazz genres, but I do know jazz music. So, but this is a great album. Jaco Pastorius is really that artist that sticks out for me here. He's an incredible bass player, and he uses the electric bass, which is different for jazz. And this is Weather Report, Night Passage. The different albums that they've released over the years are incredible. This is not their most famous album. I believe Heavy Weather is the name of the album or the song that you should check out. But this is a good album to own and a good gateway into jazz. Jaco Pastorius' solo stuff is very good too. He's just an incredible artist. He's only, like, he towers. I think he's, like, 6 feet tall. Like, over, I don't know, 6'5 or something. He's huge. He's got these big fingers, and he can just, you know, pluck away at the bass. But, what else do I have here? Okay. We're going to do one more after this. This is, when somebody asked me, hey, Rob, like, you know, what, you know, I love punk rock, I love alternative, I love indie music, but I don't really know jazz. What should I get into? I say Saxophone Colossus by Sonny Rollins. And, he's got some artists you probably never heard of on here, but, the song that you should start with is St. Thomas. Really, really cool song, really great album. This guy really knows how to play the tenor sax. The matrix number on this is not an original pressing. If you wanted to get an original pressing, it would go for about $500. Okay, here it is. It's OJC-291 is the matrix number on that. And to close out today's video, Miles at his best. Bitches Brew. I mean, look at the album artwork. I think this is Miles on drugs. To be frank. I mean, there's blood on this woman's face. I think this is more coming at a time when there was a struggle in America. In 1970, there was a lot of problems with heroin and drugs and race. And I think he embodies all of that into the group micro grooves of this album, Bitches Brew. This is also not an original pressing, but it is a legacy recording with Columbia. And this one speaks for itself. If you've ever heard of jazz before, then you've heard of Bitches Brew. It's like Afrocentricity, if that were jazz. And this is really, really cool. So check this out. Anyways, that's some thoughts from the big chair, the blue chair. I'm Rob Moran. We have a new shop available in... on the website, which just recently launched, which is omegamusicblog.com. Please feel free to check us out. I'll post the link in the comment section. If you have a comment or a jazz album that I missed, or you want me to review something, please feel free to post it in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching my video.